You may recognize that song. It's Valentine, sung by country superstar Martina McBride. The chart topper is one of the best known compositions from world-renowned pianist Jim Brickman, who you saw in that video with McBride. Now, Jim has collaborated with other stars such as Lady Antebellum, Michael Bolton. He's been nominated for 2 Grammys and currently on the road performing a Christmas celebration for fans. It is such a pleasure to have you in our studio this morning.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So you're set to perform a Christmas celebration tonight at the Widener Center in Green Bay.
Yeah, it's our entire tour. The entire month has been a holiday celebration, and tonight sort of a New Year's Eve celebration.
Yeah. So what can people expect if they've not been to this before?
Well, it's certainly a lot of fun, and there's a lot of variety in the show. Of course, we do songs like that one, like Valentine, but also a lot of holiday music as well, and a great variety. A lot of special guests joining me. You're going to meet them in just a moment. Ann Cochran, who's always been with me when I've been at the Widener Center, and special guest star, Super Bowl champion Mr. Benjamin Utek. He's going to be singing tonight as well. And on the electric violin, Tracy Silverman. He plays everything from Led Zeppelin to you know, Auld Lang Syne. So it's a little bit of everything, and I think a very lighthearted evening, something that a little bit of something for everyone.
Yeah, tell us a little bit where your music began, background began, and how'd you get started? Because you don't come from a musical family, do you?
No, I don't. In fact, I grew up in Cleveland, Ohio. I would say, you know, early on in my songwriting, it was fairly plebeian. I mean, I was kind of just an ordinary songwriter, you know. But I grew up and loving music and always wanting to write music, and along the way, just, you know, filled my passion with songwriting and playing in bands and stuff like that. And then for a long time, I did commercials for TV and radio, so jingles, and so it was kind of the early beginnings for me.
Yeah, jingles, like for McDonald's.
Yeah, well, it was fun. I mean, I had a lot of fun doing jingles, but the music now, a lot of my albums that feature solo piano music are meant to be escape. They're meant to be relaxation and, you know, romantic and inspirational. And a lot of people find that the albums that mostly have solo piano music on them are good to just chill out to at a time in the world when we all need a little bit of relaxation time with our music.
Yeah, your music career has taken you, I mean, literally around the world. I mean, you've got, you know, Grammy nominations, you've collaborated with these huge artists. I mean, where else has it brought you?
Well, certainly as a songwriter, because that's really what I think of myself as more than anything. One of the great things about having all the duet partnerships with different artists is that they bring the songs to life in a unique way. So on one hand, you can have, you see Ann Cochran there, she's going to be with us tonight. Mm-hmm. You have somebody like Olivia Newton-John on the same album as you have Carly Simon or Lady Antebellum or Wayne Brady or, you know, Kenny G or somebody. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, it's a really cool thing to be able to have eclectic duet partners that give the albums great variety, with the common thread being my songwriting.
Do you have a favorite who you collaborated with?
I do.
Can you say?
Well, yeah, actually, he's making an appearance tonight. Kermit the Frog.
Oh!
Yeah,
Kermit's
my favorite collaborator.
Now, Kermit, he's out with the Muppets.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he might take a little bit break. Actually, he's out on with Muppets on Ice right now, but he might come back and join us tonight.
That is fantastic.
But it is a great show, and, you know, we haven't been here in a long time. We were down at Appleton the last time we were here, and haven't been in the Widener Center probably for about 5 years. So I'm very excited to celebrate, and it is a great time in between Christmas and New Year's for people to come out and just escape for a few hours, have some joy in the singing and some lighthearted humor and some great singing, great singer. So
yeah, I think that's exactly what your music does. It just kind of takes you to this whole other place.
I hope so.
You're so talented. And you know what? It's been a great talking with you this morning, but we are so excited to get to hear Jim and, you know, the rest of his crew perform. And we're going to be hearing that a little bit later this morning, in fact, around 7:45. So you're not going to want to miss it. Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
It was such a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you.